Hello everyone, welcome back. After a long time, another video on non-cooperation movement. That is, this video is non-cooperation movement in countryside. In the last lecture we saw non-cooperation movement in towns. So here in countryside, participation by the peasant was in non-cooperation movement. Peasants participated. That is, in Awadh, UP, Baba Ramchandra, a sannyasi and an indentured laborer is nothing but an Indian laborer of Fiji or any other country who worked for British. The Indian people who went from India to other country like Fiji and worked in the plantation fields of Britishers. So Baba Ramchandra was a Fijian who came back to India in Awadh and started, and you can say he gave a he indulged or included himself in non-cooperation movement. In Awadh, Baba Ramchandra, a sannyasi and an indentured laborer, led the peasants against talukdars and landlords who demanded high rent from peasants. So in countryside, the non-cooperation movement was against talukdars and the landlords. Peasants movement demanded reduction of revenue, abolition of beggar. Now beggar is nothing but forced labor without pay. They used to force them to work and just to not give them pay. Who? The Britishers. The peasant movement demanded what all? Reduction of revenue, abolition of beggar, and social boycott of oppressive landlords. They wanted to boycott these landlords who were very oppressive. In towns, people were revolting direct against Britishers, as I explained in the last video. But here in countryside, it was revolt against talukdars and landlords. In fact, in both the revolts, it was against injustice. People deprived landlords from the basic service of nai dhobis. Okay, means what? They stopped the basic service that they gave to the landlords, which is nai means barber, the one who cuts hair, and dhobi, the washerman. So it was a basic service which was not being provided to the landlords and the talukdars. Okay, and not the Britishers here in countryside. So Awadh Kisan Sabha was set up by Jawaharlal Nehru and Baba Ramchandra. So this is a one mark question. The last time who headed non-cooperation movement in countryside, that was also a one mark question. So keep this in mind. Who set up Awadh Kisan Sabha? Jawaharlal Nehru and Baba Ramchandra during non-cooperation movement in countryside. But peasants movement made congressmen very unhappy because they adopted violent means, attacked on the house of talukdars and merchants, bazaars were looted. That is, basically Jawaharlal Nehru also accepted the concept of non-violence, but Gandhiji had started non-cooperation movement under non-violence. But here peasants adopted violence means. Okay, even Baba Ramchandra adopted violence means. They started attacking talukdars' houses, merchants, and bazaars were being looted. Here name of Gandhiji was invoked to sanction all actions and aspirations. Means that the peasants had assumed that Gandhiji did not oppose violent method. Okay, so they felt that Gandhiji, it can by hook or crook, he want justice. His fight was against injustice, but it was not very well spread all over that Gandhiji was against violence. He was a non-violent activist. okay, activist. So this was an that is invoked or assumed by the people, by the peasants, that Gandhiji was standing for violent methods, but it was not so. So this is about countryside. Then participation by tribals in non-cooperation movement. In Gudam Hills, that is in Andhra Pradesh, militant guerrilla movement spread in that is everywhere. There were strict forest policies of colonial government. That is, there were many policies like inland emigration policies and many other policies. Reserved forests were there, wherein they were not allowed to move in and out. The tribals were not allowed to move in and out. So enraged hill people, means tribal people, as the forest law affected their livelihoods and their tradition. How did that affect their livelihood? That is, their life was depended on the forest to collect fruits, hunt animals, stay in the wild protection. That is, they were depended on the plantation also, vegetation also, and they were not allowed to move in. They wanted wood to build their house as well as fuel, and it was a tradition, and thus it was the traditional right was being taken away by the Britishers. They were also forced for beggar. Again, beggar means forced labor. Aluri Sitaram Raju headed the national movement in for the tribals. Here Aluri Sitaram Raju. So this is also again one mark question. In countryside, it was Baba Ramchandra. In tribal, it was Aluri Sitaram Raju. He claimed of special powers. Who? Aluri Sitaram Raju. He was a person who claimed of special power. He said that I have special power. He told astrological prediction. He predicted the future. He said he can heal people. He said he could even survive bullet shots. So rebels claimed, rebels in the sense the tribals who believed him, claimed that he was the incarnation of God. Okay. He supported Gandhiji as he was impressed by non-cooperation movement, persuaded people to wear khadi and give up drinking, but believed in the use of violence. Again, here like Baba Ramchandra, he also believed in violence. Raju, that is Aluri Sitaram Raju, was captured and executed in 1924 by the Britishers. So this is about participation of non-cooperation by tribals. So now, NCM, that is non-cooperation movement in plantation field, what was it? Plantation workers had their own notion of Swaraj. They wanted freedom. That is, they wanted right to move freely in and out of the confined space of plantation field. Means retain a link between village from which they had come. So in plantation, workers voluntarily came to plantation field and started working. When they came in plantation workers, as plantation workers, an Inland Emigration Act in 1859 was passed. In this act, workers were not permitted to leave the tea garden without permission, or any plantation garden without permission. So due to non-cooperation movement, workers felt Gandhi Raj will arrive. Means they'll get freedom from this Inland Immigration Act. And so workers headed towards their home. Without the permission of Britishers, they started moving towards their home. But they never reached their destination, as on the way to their destination, they were caught by the police and brutally beaten up. Okay, so this happened to the poor people in plantation fields, workers in plantation field. Though the notions were different, but it created an emotion relating to all India agitation. Means everywhere, all over the world, everyone were fighting for injustice. It can be a plantation workers, it can be tribal people, it can be countryside people, it can be town, in the town. As the pain was felt the same, there was sense of collectiveness and belongingness. Now the sense of collectiveness and belongingness had started in India. Here there was a slogan demanding Swatantra Bharat. Everywhere it was this slogan arrived during non-cooperation movement. When did this non-cooperation movement ended? Call off of non-cooperation movement. At Chauri Chaura, a place in UP, in 1922, non-cooperation movement was called off. Called off in the sense stopped. The peaceful demonstration which was going on in the bazaar turned into violent clash with the police. That is, a peaceful demonstration was going on, police attacked them, started beating up. Then in return, these demonstrators, they burned the police station and other British institution. When this happened, Gandhiji was upset. Again, he felt that people are still not ready, they are not trained for non-violent movement, they are not trained for satyagraha, and thus Gandhiji called a halt to non-cooperation movement. Again, this is one mark question. At what place non-cooperation movement was called off or stopped? It is Chauri Chaura in UP, 1922. Thank you. The next video will be on civil disobedience movement.